tuned. Judgment Day, next.
E3 2004, it is the 10th anniversary of E3.
That's right. Here, hold this.
What? Where are you going?
I'm going to go see the show.
What? You're just leaving me here? I'm going too. Okay, we're gonna get this party started off with a bang. We're standing in front of the Xbox booth because we're gonna talk about all of the stuff that's available for the Xbox this year. And before we get started,
yes,
this is the 10-year anniversary of E3.
That's true.
Which is awesome. It's also the 10-year anniversary of Tommy and I meeting.
That's right.
So I wanted to wish you a congratulations, man.
10-year, do you have a present for me?
I do. We get to talk about all of the games at E3 this year.
Oh.
All right, well, let's talk about the Xbox. What did you like on the Xbox?
It's all about Xbox Live this year around. Prince of Persia 2 looks phenomenal.
Wow.
Some of the lighting effects. You can actually chop guys, slice them right in half this year around. Speaking of Ubisoft, Far Cry Instincts.
Awesome looking
game. Great game on the PC.
And
now it's coming to the console.
They've got Ghost Recon 2, which they put in Unreal sort of engine stuff into, so it looks a little closer to Rainbow Six. And Rainbow Six 3, Black Arrow, an expansion pack. They keep going like this. E3 is going to be like... It's just going to be Ubisoft.
Right, well, them and EA.
Yeah.
That's the big news.
All right.
All of their sports games on Xbox Live.
I was interviewing somebody, and they said that it was actually the gamers' voices out there that made them make the decision to put EA's games on Xbox Live. The spotlight's definitely on EA, and it's not just the sports games. They've also got Battlefield Modern Combat, which is an update to Battlefield 1942, which looks beautiful.
Right.
They've got the GoldenEye Rogue Agent game, Xbox Live.
What about StarCraft Ghost?
Yes.
On the Xbox.
Beautiful.
It's looking great.
Lizard.
Fable. I think I'm really going to love Fable. I was playing Fable.
Absolutely.
I think that's the most exciting RPG, to come out.
Did you play Jade Empire, though? Insane. You have all these, you have 30 different martial arts styles in the game.
Right.
So you get into the combat.
You want to talk about online? You want to talk about Xbox Live? Let's talk about Rocky Legends.
Right.
My boy
online
Rocky.
Now, man.
And it's all about Tron!
Don't scare people like that, man.
That's killer app!
Well, let's hit on some more of the first party games from Microsoft, because they've got some real stunners. Of course, everybody's talking about Halo 2. It's not playable on the show floor. I saw it at the press conference. They showed some multiplayer gaming. Unbelievable. Beautiful looking game. November 9th, it comes out. Unreal Championship 2.
Unreal Championship 2.
Looks amazing, too.
Sounds amazing.
First and third person in Unreal Championship 2.
I loved Advent Rising.
Yes.
I thought was unbelievable.
Very slick.
Very cinematic. Very awesome storyline.
There's also Men of Valor, which is a Vietnam fighting game. Very gritty. Lots of blood flying everywhere.
Shell Shock, Nam 67.
Loved the new Star Wars first-person shooters. We have two different kinds. Republic Commando is kind of like a Rainbow Six-style squad-based tactical combat game. And then, I think one of the games, probably in my top five that I'm most excited about at E3, Star Wars Battlefront. This game is what I've been waiting for since 1997. It's basically Battlefield 1942 in the Star Wars universe. Incredible graphics. It's from Pandemic, who've been kicking ass. They just did Full Spectrum Warrior.
Full Spectrum Warrior looks
amazing.
Unbelievable for THQ.
Doom 3. We haven't talked about the lighting and the shading and the fog effects.
Doom 3 is incredible. It's all about the lighting.
It looks like a movie. Great year all around for the Xbox. I was surprised that there weren't that many first-party games, but it more than made up for it. Third-party. I mean, even like Spider-Man 2 from Activision.
Spider-Man 2. I didn't even talk about Spider-Man. That's how crazy it is. But there was nothing that like every single person was talking about.
Right.
But overall, an amazing showing. Their best showing yet. I'm giving the Xbox booth an 8.5.
I'm going to give it a 9. I got to say that I kind of agree with you. But a ton of games that I really want to play are coming out on the Xbox. It's getting a 9 from me. So there you go. Another very impressive showing from Microsoft Xbox.
If there are people out there who have an Xbox and who aren't on Xbox Live yet, you better sign up now. You got to sign up now. It's unbelievable.
Lots of great titles for Xbox. When we come back, though, we're going to be talking about Nintendo. And, of course, they've got some very interesting things to talk about. Stick around. We'll be right back.
Thank you. believe there's a hero in all of us.
Wednesday, rated PG-13. XM Satellite Radio. Over 100 digital channels you'll never want to be without. With 100% commercial-free music, plus news, sports, and talk for under $10 a month. XM Satellite Radio.
New juicy fruit grape or melon. Cool.
Ah! Wait, what are you doing, man?
Mine. Sweet. Jackets.
Gotta have Twisted Sweet.
Yeah.
Gotta have the twisted fruit combinations of new juicy fruit, grape or melon, and strappleberry.
Tech TV and G4 have come together. And you can get in on the action with G4 Tech TV's Digital Dig Sweepstakes. You could be the winner of a $100,000 tech makeover for your home. From bedroom to living room, the G4 Tech TV experts will tech out your home. It's G4 Tech TV's Digital Dig Sweepstakes starting June 14th. For more info, log on to g4techtv.com/digitaldigs.
All right, we're back. We just came out of the Nintendo booth, and we're about to get down to it because we have so much stuff to talk about with Nintendo. They've got everything coming out this year. All right, well, let's start with the GameCube. What did you think of the stuff on the GameCube?
Well, you know, I mean, it's the same old, same old. They have a couple of really cool new titles. They got Geist, which looks kind of neat.
Geist, I would agree with you, looks
Geist
very cool.
Geist is great. You can possess other people. Yep. You can even play a dog.
I like that one
I think
very
my
much.
Favorite game in the whole Nintendo area was Resident Evil 4.
Looks beautiful.
Amazing graphics.
Yes.
They finally are starting to get the controls right, you
yes.
know. I saw Toilet Paper Mario 2.
Right.
You know,
Mario 2.
Oh.
There's no toilet in that title.
I saw Donkey Kong Bongo.
That would be Donkey Konga.
All Donkey right. Konga.
And there's Donkey Kong Jungle Beat. So you have two games that take advantage of the new drum peripheral that Nintendo's putting out for the Cube. The GameCube game of the show definitely is Metroid Prime Echoes. That game looks phenomenal. It's got the multiplayer action in there. Another cool GameCube game that I'm looking forward to is the Zelda. The next Zelda's going to look like the Zelda that we wanted a few years ago.
No more cell shading.
And Four Swords, this is the game that best illustrates why Nintendo was excited about connectivity. You can hook up four Game Boy Advances and you can play together. Very, very fun.
But if they're so interested in connectivity, why not give us online games? Hello.
Well, what I find is kind of strange is that they've done that in the DS, but they're definitely not going for online on the GameCube. Let's move on then from the GameCube stuff to the Game Boy Advance, which, in my opinion, had a more interesting showing than the GameCube stuff.
Now, I'm a huge Mario Party freak.
Yes.
And we got Mario Party on the Game Boy Advance.
We sure do.
I love that.
Now, Mario's going to be in all kinds of games. We've got Mario Pinball. They've also got Mario Golf, which looks fantastic. But definitely the Game Boy Advance game that I am most excited about, it's the new Legend of Zelda, the Minish Cap. It has the Wind Waker Zelda art style in the game, and it looks like it's going to be so much fun.
We love Zelda and the Windbreaker.
We love Zelda. And I love Zelda. There's also a very interesting thing that they're packing in with the new Pokemon games now. We've got a wireless connector, so people that play Pokemon Leaf Green and Fire Red, they can communicate wirelessly on their GBAs now, which is kind of cool. You know, I think the GBA had a very cool showing.
I thought it had a better showing than the GameCube. Would you agree with that?
I would agree.
I would agree with that.
I'm looking forward to a lot of the Game Boy Advance games, definitely.
Now, speaking of portable systems, we got to talk about the Nintendo DS.
Nintendo DS.
Two screens, the new portable. I got to say that this isn't the finished version, but right now the buttons are way too small.
Right.
It's very thick. I want to get your opinion, but to me, the PSP blows it out of the water.
Well, here's my thoughts on the DS. It was the big mystery coming into the show. Nobody knew what Nintendo was up to. And they've definitely come out with something that's very, very innovative. I love the touchscreen applications.
Yeah, you have a touchscreen, and it's going to come with a stylus.
Yeah, I mean, there's a game
wireless.
There's wireless networking, Wi-Fi, and a sort of a Bluetooth derivative, so you can be in closer proximity or over the internet and play games.
And thank God they have a headphone jack, which is always nice to see.
But then with the touchscreen, you can do cool things. Like, there was a game where you could draw Pac-Man, and he would chase after the ghost. That was part of the game. So you had to draw Pac-Man as quickly as you could to capture all the things.
My concern is this, is that the games that they were showing in there,
yeah.
I personally, as a gamer, I wouldn't buy any of them.
But
I mean, they had Metroid Prime on there.
Metroid Hunters.
Running
very
a little slow.
Cool. No, I thought it was great. And what was different about that game, too, is that you controlled all of the weaponry with the stylus. You look around with the stylus, and you tap the button on the enemies to kill them.
But I don't think that game is really going to...
Not that one game, no.
One game isn't going to do it, because,
they had some other cool ones, though.
Well,
they
there's the Mario.
Yeah, Super Mario 64 times 4. It's a four-player game set in the Mario 64 world,
right,
with all the different Mario characters.
I'm going to wait to see...
What the other titles
if
are.
There's other, because I got to be honest with you, PSP, I don't care how much it is, I'm going to buy that thing.
Yeah, not everybody's
awesome.
Got your credit card, though.
Awesome.
That's the deal.
But if somebody has to make a decision between which one to get, how can you tell them not to wait for the PSP?
I know. I got to say, I enjoyed the PSP stuff a little bit more. I liked what they were showing a little bit more than the DS. Yeah, I mean, we just don't know what's coming out yet. So
right.
I'm excited. I have faith in Nintendo, especially in the handheld department. I know that they recognize the threat that Sony's putting on there. If you had to score the Nintendo booth and what you're seeing from Nintendo this year and for Nintendo, what would you give it?
I'd give it a 5.5.
Wow, man. You are really disappointed.
Well... Hey,
that's a very low score.
Compared to Sony and Xbox and the PC stuff.
Well, I'll tell you this. I am not as excited about the software that Nintendo is showing. I want to play more of the games on the Xbox and the PlayStation 2. But I think the DS is a cool showing. Very impressed with the GBA. And there are definitely some cool GameCube games that I want to play. 7.5 out of 10. So we're done with Nintendo. But don't worry. There's lots more show to come when we come back. We're talking about PC games.
The legend grows. The new, longer Jeep Wrangler Unlimited, with more legroom, twice the cargo space, and trail-rated capability. Only in a Jeep 4x4.
Buried Treasure is brought to you by EB Games. We take games seriously.
I found a classic game that I want to talk about today in Buried Treasure. This is Metal Gear Solid for the Game Boy Color. Now, I know what you're saying. Every Metal Gear game is super successful, and this doesn't really qualify as a buried treasure, but I did mention that it's for the Game Boy Color, didn't I? And nobody has that system anymore. But what's great about this thing is that it really pulled in a lot of the details that you're seeing in all of the Metal Gear games out there. You're still talking on your communicator with all the same codecs to Campbell and My Ling and all of the sort of cast of supporting characters that are part of Metal Gear. There's 180 VR missions on this cartridge, so you can actually test out some of the play mechanics of the game. And the levels in the game actually take into account all the stealthy, sneaky spy action that we love in Metal Gear. And of course, everybody's talking about Metal Gear now because we've got the Twin Snakes in the Cube, and we've got Metal Gear Solid 3 coming for the PlayStation 2. So it's a perfect time to go and find the Game Boy Color version of Metal Gear Solid. This is a great game for your Game Boy Color or your Game Boy Advance. Go check it out, Metal Gear Solid.
All right, we're back. We're gonna start talking about all of the PC games that we're seeing here at E3 2004. What did you think of the PC showing, man?
I gotta say, last year at E3, we were kinda a little disappointed because there was no innovation, really.
Yes, yeah.
It was all the same RTSs, RPGs, and first-person shooters. This year, I gotta say, big turnaround.
Right.
And we're seeing a lot of cool, innovative games on a PC. I think this is the best year in a long time for the PC.
Well, yeah, I think so too. And I think the two games that really sort of come to the forefront when you're thinking of what's happening in the PC world this year, Half-Life 2 and Doom 3 are finally going to be available.
Talking about innovation, innovative games like the movies.
Amazing game.
Peter Molyneux's game for the PC.
Amazing.
You create a movie within the game. It's unbelievable.
You can upload the movie that you create, and other people can watch it. Incredible stuff there. NCSoft has got the Guild Wars, which is one of the first free massively multiplayer games out there. Give you a little taste of that role-playing experience, that Diablo type of experience.
Lineage 2.
The charge.
Lineage 2.
Lineage 2.
Another one.
The City of Heroes is already out, but City of Villains was on the show floor. World of Warcraft. That has got to be one of the sweetest looking massively multiplayer games I've ever seen. Also love the expansion to Star Wars Galaxies, the jump to Lightspeed. Now we can fly around in spaceships. You can pilot things like the Millennium Falcon and have people inside the ship and people mounting the turrets and stuff like that. That is going to be awesome, man. Getting your own Star Wars ships.
There's even some third-person games as well, like Advent Rising.
Yes.
It's a really cool-looking cinematic game experience for the PC. You got The Matrix Online.
Matrix Online, another massively multiplayer.
Oddly enough, being done by Sega.
Yes, published by Sega, developed by Monolith, totally different for a massively multiplayer game.
The Sims 2.
That's right.
Which looks really incredible.
EverQuest 2. I just saw characters jumping into the water. That looks incredible. Lots of sweet lighting effects in that game. I mean, these massively multiplayer games, you never think of them as looking so good, but now they're just looking insane. I mean, they've got some beautiful artwork in them.
They announced Splinter Cell 3.
I know.
It's like Splinter Cell 2 just came out.
Well, I couldn't believe how quickly Pandora Tomorrow came out from the previous Splinter
That's
Cell.
That's right. The EA stuff had a new Lord of the Rings game, which
yes.
was like an RTS kind of thing.
Yes, not the Battle for Middle Earth.
Not my cup of tea.
That looks incredible.
But also, they were also showing Medal of Honor Pacific Assault,
yes,
which
nice
is going to give Call of Duty a run for its money. With the AI is absolutely incredible, completely unique every time you play the game. How about Shellshock NAM 67?
Yeah, that's going to be killer.
Like IDOS looks amazing.
That's going to be really cool. If we're getting into the shooter department, you can't ignore Stalker, which basically came out of nowhere. It's being published by THQ, and that game looks sensational, man. It's really, really nice. A very close competitor to what's being offered in Half-Life 2 and Far Cry and Doom 3. Stalker looks sick.
I thought Myst 4 looked extremely beautiful. I know that's not your style.
Not my style at all.
But
no.
I think people are really going to freak out over Myst 4. Peter Gabriel, Jack Wall doing the music.
That's right.
Unbelievable. But check this out. Playboy, the mansion game.
I knew you were going to like that one.
That is awesome. You go around.
Is that your new Tron this year?
You go around. Playboy!
It is. I knew it.
Playboy!
I knew it would be. Talking about real-time strategy games, it was cool to see Ground Control 2.
Dude, I'm surprised you haven't mentioned Dungeon Siege 2.
Great game from Microsoft.
Damn.
Totally cool game. I think the console still won the attention.
I agree.
But this was a very fun year for playing PC games. 2004 is going to be great if you're a PC owner. I'm giving it 8 out of 10.
Exactly what I give it. We finally agreed on one.
All right.
An 8 out of 10.
Sweet. Well, stick around. We're coming right back with a look at the PlayStation 2 games coming out this year.
The greatest commanders don't just deliver their men to victory. They deliver them home. Full Spectrum Warrior, rated mature, played on Xbox Live.
What are your dreams? Do they include playing video games? Or making video games? Or both? Stop dreaming. Pick up the phone, call Collins College, and start a career doing what you love in the new game design program. Call 1-888-256-1200 now. That's 1-888-256-1200.
G4 TV for gamers and tech TV are connecting to Form G4 Tech TV. Stay connected. For more information, go to g4techtv.com.
G4 Tech TV is giving away a $100,000 home tech makeover, brought to you by Circuit City and Yahoo. For the next 2 weeks, G4 Tech TV is collecting entries.
Watch every night from 6 p.m. to 1 a.m. Eastern, now through the 27th, and look for the sweepstakes commercials because they contain secret codes. Every time you see a code, go to the website and enter.
And remember, for all the news in the world of games, make sure to watch what you play right here on Pulse.
G4 TV for gamers and tech TV are connecting to form the only network taking digital entertainment to the next level.
Sound fun?
I love video games.
Plugged in to every aspect of games, gear, gadgets, and gigabytes.
That was unexpected, right?
Okay.
You're watching G4 Tech TV.
G4 Tech TV. Stay connected. For more information, go to g4techtv.com.
All right, we're back. We're here at the PlayStation booth, and man, is Sony having a huge year this year.
I mean, once again, Sony shows why they're so dominant in the industry, why they are the top in the world. This is the best booth here at the show. Hands down, Gran Turismo 4.
All right.
The best looking driving game we've ever seen.
What about Burnout 3?
Burnout 3 is
on the
incredible.
PlayStation 2.
I mean, it's Hollywood.
So beautiful.
It's Hollywood filmmakers getting together with video game makers to create all these amazing crashes
incredible.
And everything.
And now at Need for Speed Underground 2 is there. So if you're a racing fanatic that has a PlayStation 2, not only are you going to get incredible games, you're going to be able to play them online.
Final Fantasy 12.
Very
exclusive
very
to PlayStation
game.
2.
Developed by the guys that did Final Fantasy Tactics series.
Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater. You want to eat my snake? You can do it now. How about God of War?
Looks great.
Another exclusives game.
Next
this
year.
Looks like an Xbox game.
Coming out, sweet looking game.
That's the thing, is that all the PlayStation
the
2 games. To Mark Akree.
Rise of Kasai.
Right.
Sweet looking game. Rao is back. He's killing people. He still looks like a little cute cartoon, but he's vicious.
How about this?
Awesome.
Sly Cooper?
Yes.
We got Sly 2, and it looks unbelievable.
Yes. And we're talking action platformer style games. You can't forget Jack 3, which
oh
is incredible
God.
Now. They've added more vehicles.
Tons of, you can get on monsters and ride them around the city.
You've got online in Ratchet
Getting
and Clank up your arsenal, where they named it for Tommy Tallarico.
They did.
It's a very cool game.
It's online.
It's a single player, and you get an online thing, so you've got cute cartoon creatures kicking the living out of each other.
You can't say that.
Did I say that?
Rumble Roses,
yes.
Which is an all-girl, hot chick fighting
Wrestling
game.
I know, it looks
G-strings,
crazy.
Bouncing boobies, tons of iToy support
yes.
this year. Harry Potter game from EA has the iToy support.
I like the Sega Superstars. You're beating up on the zombies from House of the Dead and the Virtual Fighter dudes.
That's right.
I also dug the anti-grab game, which is kind of like
Slip Groove or something.
Yeah, exactly. I was also digging Mortal Kombat Deception on the PlayStation 2. Great big fighters, lots of gore, exactly what you want. Now, in terms of shooters, we've got some killer ones. Killzone. From Guerrilla Games, they did the NOM Shell Shock 67.
25 really, really to Life, which is like Grand Theft Auto
yes.
from IDOS.
That's actually, it felt a little bit more like SOCOM to me, but
you're
it's
right.
SOCOM in the hood kind of deal.
Prince of Persia 2 on the PlayStation
beautiful,
2.
Beautiful.
Incredible, you can slice guys in half now. The Incredibles looks amazing, the new Pixar Disney film.
There are also some really great sequels to see again. Really big fan of ATV Off-Road Fury.
That's
number
right.
3.
Online.
Voice communication now, finally, that's going to be awesome. And also awesome to see the Getaway Black Monday. I really enjoyed the ambition of the last game.
Yeah, true.
But this time they're sweetening everything up.
Hopefully the controls are better.
And of course we have a brand new Grand Theft Auto game, San Andreas. So, you know, all in all, PlayStation 2 lineup is unbelievable.
Well, here's the thing. We've talked about all the iToy support.
Yeah.
We've talked about all the exclusive games on the Sony, but factor all that in, and we have the announcement of the PSP. It is the most incredible handheld system ever.
It was very surprising to me because I was at the press conference and it looked larger when you saw it on the big screen.
It is so cool looking.
But it's tiny.
They
very,
got
very
clear.
Sleek.
There's clear buttons on the
yes.
top. It looks so amazing.
EA has announced NFL Street, NBA Street, Need for Speed Underground 2,
Gran Turismo 4, Twisted Metal's up and running right now.
Yeah, we saw
Metal
Wipeout.
Gear Solid up and running right now.
We saw Wipeout on there. Very cool.
So what do you give the whole Sony area then, my friend?
Incredible showing for the PlayStation 2, but it was really about the PSP for me this year. Sony kicked ass again, 9.5, an incredible showing.
I'm with you, absolutely. 9.5 on the Sony area.
So there it is, E3 2004 is all over and done. Thousands of people streaming out now. They've seen thousands of games. What did you think of the show overall?
I gotta say that Ubisoft booth was, to me, the best booth in there.
One game you wanna play the most?
Splinter Cell 3, maybe Prince of Persia 2. But for me, the three greatest things in my life, Spider-Man, Tron, and
me.
Rocky.
Oh, Rocky.
Best E3 ever. I know we say that every year.
This was an incredible E3.
But this is the best E3 ever.
The PSP is the most exciting thing about E3 2004 for me.
Right.
But I'm also very excited to play games like Half-Life 2. Very surprised by the quality of Pandemic's titles. Destroy All Humans looks incredible.
I'll tell you what I think the most incredible thing at the show was.
Yes.
The Unreal 3 right. engine technology.
Yes. I can't wait for next year. Lots of great games to play until then. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys had as much fun as we did. We'll see you next time.
You to choose which games win at this year's G4ia, the award show for gamers. Go to g4techtv.com/g4ia and decide who gets best game, character, soundtrack, and more. Press, vote, and make your voice heard. It's all part of G4ia, presented by EB Games and Jeep.